name is Camille Lancicone. It is a pleasure to welcome you to Positive Steps into Social Mobility, Awareness and Empowerment. Whatever you do in life, you are bound to experience social mobility as you move from one set of circumstances to the next, circumstances with coincidences that enables you to move ahead in your life. For example, having an education. Having an education is a social mobility. Whether it is from the University of Life or an academic place of study. First and foremost, as with everything, it is what you do with the tools and resources that you have that dictates how this aspect of social mobility benefits you. Secondary is how it benefits your family, then how it benefits your community, and how it benefits your professional development and your work partners. In essence, it all begins with you. You put the effort in and you receive the reward. People like you, who have already taken their first and subsequent steps into social mobility, gather speed through being able to readily utilize social circumstances to their benefit. You have been at the lower social positions. You survived it. You gained strength of character from it. You are mentally and or physically scarred from the experiences. Now the only way is up. You are determined to make it in life. You are determined to change your set of circumstances. Why not you? Why not now? You still have the fear of not being acknowledged with anything special. You still have the fear of not of being a fraud amongst special people. You still have the fear of not being accepted by people better than you. You still have many fears, and these fears hound you during the day and during the night. You fight with yourself in your head about how inadequate you are and how no one gives you a chance in life. You are ready for the greatest step forward. You truly, truly are the greatest step out of your comfort zone, the greatest step away from your fears. There are many people who were once where you are right now from all across the world who are looking to help others similar to themselves into social mobility. These particular groups of people have this innate need to help others who remind them of themselves, wanting to get ahead in life from a position of social and professional poverty, negligence, setbacks, hardships, and barriers. Sometimes those that are ahead in social mobility see an aspect of their beloved mother, father, brother, or sister in others, such as you, feeling a need to help you because of this remembrance. The other side to that is that there are people who are born into or are deeply ingrained into the abuse of social mobility in a morbid, pompous manner due to their established family or social connections. They will use you like a slave through your lack of know-how in social mobility and through your goodwill to others. Many of us who have made the steps into social mobility from an impoverished or deficient upbringing have experienced such grotesque, pompous people. These types of people are to be avoided at all costs. You do not have your name associated with them. You definitely do not need to give them the time of day. You do not connect with them on social media. You do not connect with them professionally. Once you give these terrible people the use of your name, your time, and your money, they will use and abuse you until you cease to be useful to them. They will, and they do, trample on you. You have been warned. Remember that you are important. You are content, and your content equals currency. Let no one take that away from you, especially not complete strangers. Never mind the members of your own family or community. I will give you one example of how I came across such despicable people, pompous in the extreme. About 22 years ago, I was attending a private club event with two other friends in London, an event where one had to purchase a ticket. The ticket included a welcome glass of champagne per guest. Our arrival was sufficient, as stated on the event guidance. As I inquired at the bar about a glass of champagne, I was informed by the bartender that the champagne had finished, and he nodded towards a group of pompous white people, because they were pompous and because they were white. These people were fairly rowdy and had several empty glasses by them at a table. A number of them looked at me as if to suggest that I should not be in attendance at such a place as this, unless I was a part of the waiting staff. Some of these people I had recognized from a previous social event a year earlier in Stockholm, Sweden. They had portrayed the same bad manners to other guests and saw no shame in stealing drinks off the tables of others. One of the men then came over to me and gave me an order to provide more drinks to the group, meaning that I should pay for their drinks. The bartender looked mortified, and another waiting staff was shocked by the rudeness of this particular guest. Needless to say, I dealt with the situation in the best way possible. I stood tall and confident in my stature. Ignoring the idiot, I asked the waiting staff if they knew the whereabouts of the host. Having received the reply, I gave my thanks and elegantly turned away in the direction of where the host was to be found, which, fortuitously, was where my other two friends were, as they were having a conversation with the host, whom they both knew. Goodness, I could tell you several encounters with such vulgar, pompous people. When you attend one of our silver service dining events, more will be divulged by our members, in order to stand you in good stead from such situations. The sharing of experiences will stand you in good stead. We have all been through such rudeness and come out at the other end more victorious through the positive steps that you will get to know. But for now, this is not solely about those types of pompous fools. Within Positive Steps into Social Mobility, there is an insight into such people and their fear of people like you, from humble beginnings, looking different, having strange accents, so on and so forth, moving forward and upwards in society through knowing the actions, behaviors, and introductions that will open up opportunities for you. Opportunities that you gather at a steady pace. Positive Steps into Social Mobility is about you and the people like you who are walking through the social barriers and becoming prosperous in doing so with like-minded people across the world. In Social Mobility, there is a strong connection to emotional psychology, to others who are like-minded. This is swiftly followed by how can this new introduction be beneficial to a particular situation. Invariably, the situation, if it is not apparent immediately, becomes apparent in a short space of time. Some people call it a coincidence of circumstances. I will give you an example. This is where an invitation for a guest plus one has your name written upon it as the plus one. You become vital as a connection for that new contact that you made at a previous event. Your positive steps enabled and proved to others observing you that you could be a part of something bigger, better, and special through a recommendation. At events, people will observe how you are dressed and how you conduct yourself. Like attracts like, and we all know that opposites attract. Sometimes you are lumbered with people that, or bothered with people that you have not chosen to be with and whom you would not normally wish to associate with. This is where you make your mark to show your caliber of character and strength so that you come out of the situation as the victor. Something as simple as stalking tables for full or half empty wine glasses and drinking the last drop of alcohol instantly tags a person under many descriptions. Descriptions that you are already thinking of as you visualize the scenario. Imagine observing a guest scratching under their armpits and smelling their hands at a dinner table. This is one sign of social inadequacy to ever be considered as a potential social or professional contact. Even if the guest spoke 10 languages and knew how to waltz, such a guest failed to observe the dining etiquette, never mind the social etiquette, and continued to show little acknowledgement of the embarrassment that was placed upon the other guests at the table. I came across such a person at an event, and I was in need of someone who was multilingual and had an interesting personality who could mix well with a small gathering of people who were invited to an embassy event in Paris, France. Needless to say, this person would have been invaluable due to the international guest list. However, having observed this armpit scratching behavior in special company, having this person included as a guest was an absolute no. There are certain expectations in social mobility, and once the line has been crossed, it is a matter of proving oneself again and again to ascertain a confidence level and trust from others who may give the benefit of the doubt and forgive and forget. Even if someone does forgive and forget such an unforgettable social episode, the degree of invitations to events for that person will be slim, and the interaction will be negligible. It may be that someone with tact and time would need to take a person with this lack in social skills to one side and delicately explain what they should and should not be doing in company. How one presents oneself in special or important circumstances is everything. It is crucial. It can dictate how fortunate you become through the connections with others who have the ability to bestow you with situations where you can access opportunities and prosperity. With like-minded people, the opportunities and prosperity gathers growth. Sometimes, when you enter into social mobility and receive an invitation to an event, or when you choose to take your first step to a ticket-held event, you are nervous, as you know very little people at the event. Or, as more is the case, you know no one at the event. In such circumstances, you have the ability to come away more confidently with at least one mutually beneficial connection. This, through having had the positive steps into social mobility guide you through a situation which you are now able to handle with trust and belief in yourself. Imagine not having that foresight and entering a room full of people and not knowing when to enable a start or excuse yourself from a situation. Your accent or dialect should never be seen as a hindrance to propelling you further in life. In fact, it is an asset. It can act as one of the advantages. It can act as one of your greatest attributes about you that makes people gravitate to you. Your accent or your dialect realizes your authenticity when connectors are looking for a specific person who has a particular knowledge or experience from a certain location. That means you. People are looking to connect with you, and your accent or dialect is the key to your opportunities. One of the most common aspects that expats and diasporas have is a gravitation towards other individuals that have similarities or interests to themselves. For example, charity work, fitness, art, literature, science, magic, gardening, the weather and nature, languages, sailing, hill walking, fishing, symbolism and mythology, sport, and definitely etiquette. Anything goes. There are no limits, but there are certain conditions in conversations and behaviors that have to be observed in a social setting. Camille here. There is one extra resource for you from me with reference to the video that you have watched. You know that you have an issue. You need help with the issue. Get that issue resolved and your questions will have the answers. Sign up for the next video and join me as I explain how to get the answers, what the answers mean, and how easily they can be applied at social functions. Plus, there is a little exclusive insight for you in a bonus video. Sign up now to take a look.